And I found something that I thought he would really like that would please him as he wakes up in the morning. And right now he is still a baby, not quite walking, almost. So he's in a crib and he's in those pastel colors that look very babyish. He's outgrowing those. He's getting too old for them. He needs to have something a little more vibrant and a little more masculine looking maybe. So this jungle is going to be his new room. Well, this wall hanging is the same thing. None of this was pieced. It was a pre-printed panel is what I have here. And you buy it just that way, buy the panel, and then stack it together to make a wall hanging and quilt it and so on. This rod I'm going to take out since I'll be working on the wall hanging a little. This was purchased, just a dowel rod that was purchased at a lumber yard, spray painted red, some fat yarn tassels hanging on it to make it a little more festive. And it can hang on that very easily then on the wall. Then to get back to the wall hanging, it's a matter of just stacking fabrics very quickly. You cut one that's the same size as the top layer, maybe a little bit larger to make sure that it's going to do the job and cover it all. But that's the back layer, and that's any kind of lining fabric you want. Here I just have a plain cotton, white, any color would do, whatever you like. In between I have a layer of quilt batting. And that's as it comes in the roll in the plastic bags, or you can buy it by the yard also. But that's what's in the center. I just have a piece of this quilt batting cut the very same size as the top layer. And then I put the top layer on top. And after you have all three of those layers stacked, just use a whole lot of big safety pins and pin the layers together all over. And after they're pinned together so that it will actually hold together nicely, then go to the serger or the sewing machine, whichever you prefer, and just do the raw edges together. Just connect them together all the way around. This was bound then later, afterwards, with some prepackaged bias tape, the wide type, so that it would bind around the edges, and that was just a simple job later at any point. You could do it now if you wanted to before you do the interior, or you could do it later whenever it's convenient. And out of that same bias tape, then I made these little tabs on the top so that it could hook over the rod and hang there. So very, very simple. This is a good project for beginners. On the zebra, I use this large one, and you can see the pre-printed mane down here underneath. And with that large one, maybe it was too big. Maybe I'll give it a little haircut after I get through and cut it down a little bit smaller. As far as how did I get this stripe mane on the zebra, we better do that to show you how easy that is. Now, I just had enough black yarn to do the black and white stripes here, so I'm doing it with navy and white, but just so that you'll get the idea of what it's all about. What I did when I wound these is the two simultaneously. So I would, for a while, wind a little black on here, and then after I had the black wound, and I better close up that little trap door again on the reed, after I'd have a little of the black wound and pushed down in place, because I kind of went with the stripes that were already here on the pre-printed panel, I just wanted that much, and then I'd wind a little bit of the white right next to it, and after I'd have a little of that white wound that would be about the same half inch worth, then I could wind a little more navy, and I just kept on alternating between the two until I had just the right size here for the mane so that it would do right. So you can see this is really easy. This one, after I finished then, I did clip all those, so it's just going between the loops and clipping it if you want to. And so, fun thing to do.